7 News reporter George Lettuce has our Commitment 2010 coverage tonight. He joins us live from the newsroom. George?
The latest polls show a race between Democratic Governor Martin O'Malley and former Governor Bob Ehrlich, a Republican, is a dead heat. And with the economy still on most voters' minds, this race has turned into who can bring Maryland back into the black.
Martin O'Malley versus Bob Ehrlich. For voters, Maryland's next governor may not come down to Democrat versus Republican.
Instead, ask themselves the Ronald Reagan question. Are you better off now than you were 4 years ago?
It's why both presumptive gubernatorial candidates are focusing their campaigns on economic platforms. Republican Bob Ehrlich just got a big endorsement from former businessman and possible presidential contender Mitt Romney. On his YouTube channel, the former governor devotes many clips to his business plan.
When it comes to business environment, the ability to track corporate headquarters to Maryland, to allow small business people in the state of Maryland to grow and to prosper.
Mr. Ehrlich has said that he's going to appoint a lot of task forces and study groups to look at ways to make Maryland more business friendly. Governor O'Malley can point out that we're really doing a lot better than other states. Our unemployment rate is about 2 percentage points less than everywhere than the nation at large.
Democrat O'Malley, who officially filed his candidacy papers today, has been on a Jobs Across Maryland tour, touting that his administration helped save or create more than 6,400 jobs since 2008, including 200 jobs at the GM plant in White Marsh.
The only way we're going to continue to be an economic leader of this world is to invest in the new generation of new technologies.
But just in the past month or so, several big employers announced job cuts. 250 at Lake Mason, almost 600 at Solo Cups. And today, Rosecroft Raceway in PG County announced its closing, threatening 200 jobs. Both campaigns quickly issued statements. Ehrlich, Rosecroft's closure is a sobering reminder of state government's failure to design a viable gaming program in Maryland. O'Malley, I've asked Secretary of State John McDonough to bring together the stakeholders and find a way forward that can protect the 200 jobs at Rosecroft.
Now, some experts suggest all this economic jockeying between the two won't make a difference for the state. They say Maryland's economy largely depends on how the national economy is doing. In the newsroom, George Lettuce, WBAL-TV 11 News.